allô. Le coq de l'école, le coq de l'école, allô, allô. Le coq de l'école, le coq de l'école, allô, allô.
What's up, Milwaukee? What's going on to the rest of the United States? This is your boy, Track Lacer. I got a lot of views when I did this last year. Maybe it's because I'm one of the first people to put them up real quick. Got about 700 views, man, so I'm hoping to get 1,000 this year. But this is my annual NBA draft lottery recap and also predictions, because now that we know what orders the teams are picking in, now I can tell you who my picks are going to be. And this is going to be a little bit different because, you know, I started to start from, as you, for those of you who don't know, the NBA draft lottery goes basically the 14 worst teams going 1 through 14 get the best college players, with it being a little bit of difference depending on how the ping pong balls landed. And this is one of the first years in NBA history every percentage landed exactly with the records of how they were supposed to. So there was no change. Nobody moved up. Nobody moved down. So with that being said, I know you excited about my first two picks. Of course, the number 10 pick with Milwaukee, I got a nice surprise for you. And by the time I conclude that, I'm also going to give you my team who I feel like got the steals of the draft tonight. All right, y'all ready? I just talked for a minute and 32 seconds. I got Mark Jackson in the background interrupting me because this Cleveland Cavaliers and Toronto Raptors game is on. But I'm so excited about this draft, I'm not even watching the game right now. So let me get into it. I got my notes, but you guys won't see him away from the camera. Okay, with the first pick in the NBA draft, the Philadelphia 76ers will select 6'10" power forward Ben Simmons out of Louisiana State University. This year, Ben Simmons averaged 19.2 points, 11.5 rebounds, and 4.9 assists. We just gonna round that off to 5. Now, here's the big thing that's been going on with Ben. They say he got a little bit of an attitude. You know, I see you, Ben. They say your attitude is a little funky. Your attitude is a little off. So there's some rumors that he might have been kind of disrespectful to some of the coaches, even though his godfather is a coach there, and that's part of the reason he chose LSU. It's some rumors that he kind of acts Hollywood on campus, kind of dismissive to the students. And then obviously it came out that he wasn't going to class. So that's raised some character concerns. Then the other big red flag of concern was his shooting. Basically, they think that he's not a good shooter. Now, I'm going to say this. Now, on the flip side of that, the other top two consensus prospect is Brandon Ingram out of Duke. And what they said about Brandon Ingram out of Duke is that he's an entire year younger. So Ben is 19. Brandon is only 18. Even though he is an inch shorter, he got the longer wingspan. So Brandon Ingram got a 7'4" wingspan, something crazy like that. And they say he's a better shooter. So the fact that he has longer arms, he's a better shooter, he's a year younger, makes him the number one pick over Brandon Ingram. Now let me ask y'all something. If I told you I got a 6'10" dude who can rebound, who can play pretty decent defense, at 6'10", he has an incredible handle, and then on top of the incredible handle, he's the best passer that has come through the NBA draft since LeBron James at 6'10". And then you telling me his only weakness is that he can't shoot. So now if we're talking about upside, isn't the person who can do everything except shoot, isn't he the one who has the more upside? Because if we've learned anything, Brandon Ingram just ain't going to get no incredible handle out of nowhere. And then out of nowhere, he just all of a sudden is going to be throwing no-look passes. You know what I mean? But shooting is the one thing in the NBA when you don't have to go to class and you can spend all the time just honing your craft, shooting becomes something that you can improve on. So because of that, I think it's crazy. And my other prediction is that with them having so many centers and power forwards, they got Jahlil Okafor, they got the big boy from Kansas, Joel Embiid, they got Nerlens Noel. Mark my words, Ben Simmons will be completely modeled after LeBron James, and he will be a 6'10" starting small forward who will run the point, basically initiate the offense. And that's going to expose his weakness for not shooting from the outside because he's going to be leading the fast break. So, okay, so enough with that. So that's your first pick, Brandon Ingram. I'm going to try to run through these other ones a little bit quicker, but had to make sure I explained that. Okay, the second pick in the NBA draft, the Los Angeles Lakers select Brandon Ingram, 6'9" freshman, small forward out of Duke. Now, I already kind of spoiled it, but the Lakers is going to be ready. Because if you put D'Angelo Russell, Jordan Clarkson at the two, oh boy, Brandon Ingram at the three, Julius Randle at the four, and then you move big slow Hibbert out the way and put in Larry Nance Jr. at the center, Lakers is going to be something to deal with. And I think it's one of those rare situations where you're almost glad that you got the number two pick. Because initially, he might show more flashes than than Ben Simmons. But trust me, in the long run, Ben Simmons is going to be the better player. Okay, I'm going to keep doing this announcer style. With the number three pick in the NBA draft, the Boston Celtics selects Dragan Bender. Now, most of y'all is going to be like, who? Dragan Bender. He is a 7-foot power forward from Croatia. So the only thing that I can tell you is that his name is escaping me right now, Porzingis. If you think about Porzingis and what he's doing for the New York Knicks at power forward at 7'2", this is a similar player. His outside shot is even nicer than Porzingis. He can shoot better than Porzingis. He's also very thin, so I'm not sure if he's going to bang down low for you. But this is something that the Boston Celtics really need. They got a lot of tough dudes, but they don't have a whole lot of skilled players. So when you take all those tough defensive-minded players that they have and add in a 7-foot lights-out three-point shooter, you know, who also, you know, all the Europeans are good passers, that's a win for them. Okay, with the number four pick in the NBA draft, the Phoenix Suns select Jaylen Brown, freshman from the University of California, 6'7" small forward. And I can tell y'all something. As you can see from my chest, in addition to Milwaukee, Wisconsin, I also represent the A, Atlanta, Georgia. And last year, I went to the game, Marietta Wheeler High School. This is the same high school as Sharif Abdul-Rahim. And ironically, Sharif Abdul-Rahim went to Cal. So I'm pretty sure he sent them a bag of money to make sure that they got this boy from Atlanta to go all the way to school in California. But I saw the boy play in person. And He has this crazy combination of a real muscular, stocky build. He weighs about 220 pounds, like solid muscle. But on top of that, he's very fast. And don't get me wrong, but athletically, it's kind of similar to LeBron James. So I'm not saying he has LeBron's handle, because he doesn't have a great handle. He doesn't have the passing skills, but just the physical skills on the court to move that fast at 220 pounds and to get that high in the air with his elevation is going to be something. And then when you put him as small forward next to Devin Booker from Kentucky with the rookie year he had last year, that's going to be a nice little mix, okay? With the sixth pick in the NBA draft, the New Orleans Pelicans select Chris Dunn, 6'4" point guard out of Providence. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this. Chris Dunn is a pure point guard. He's 6'4", and the Pelicans' point guard situation is a mess. You know, one day it's Eric Gordon. Another day it's Tyreek Evans. Another day is Drew Holiday, but all three of them dudes always seem to be hurt. Anthony Davis will be so happy to have a blue chip dude that's a pure point guard there to save the day, to come to his rescue. All right. With the seventh pick in the NBA draft, the Denver Nuggets select Buddy Hield, shooting guard, Oklahoma. Dude is a senior. You don't see seniors going in the top 10 in the draft no more. Some people had him going as high as number 3 to the Boston Celtics. But I think, you know, the Croatian boy is too much to pass up. But when you think about how physical Moutier is at the point guard for Denver, and then you slide Buddy Hield next to him, who's a pure shooter, that's a nice little combination. And I think, you know, then you got your Italian boy, Donatius, I forget his name, the one that used to play, he's like 6'11", he used to play shooting guard for the Knicks, but you put his shooting next to Buddy Hill shooting, then you still got the Manimal down low, that could really be something. So good luck into the Denver Nuggets. Okay. With the eighth pick in the draft, the Sacramento Kings select Marquise Chris. This is a 6'10" freshman power forward from the University of Washington. I don't know that much about him. They say he's real raw. They say he has a whole lot of athleticism. They already took old boy Willie Cauley-Stein last year. They already got DeMarcus down there, but maybe that means somebody's going to get traded. But for some reason, they still keep saying that they need another power forward. So they kind of in one of those situations where you got to take the best player available. You know, they can't really help that. Okay, with the ninth pick in the NBA draft, the Toronto Raptors select Jakob Poeltl. Now, this is a white boy who got some serious athleticism. He's 7 feet tall. He's a good rebounder, but he will take off on you. So this isn't just that, you know, they call him a stiff. This isn't a stiff white boy. This is a true 7-footer with some athletic skills. And, you know, the game is on right now. Toronto was in the Eastern Conference Finals against LeBron and the Cleveland Cavaliers. You add a top 10 pick to play center, they might be on to something, okay? And with the 10th pick in the NBA draft, man, hold on, man. With the 10th pick, get a good look at this hat, too. I paid $50 for this hat. It kind of surprised me, but they said this part and this part was 100% leather. I was expecting to pay the 30, you know. But with the 10th pick in the NBA draft, the Milwaukee Bucks select Henry Ellison, 6'10" power forward out of Marquette University. That's my first surprise of the draft. And they had Henry Ellison going as high as top five. He is what you really call a stretch four. He has a decent handle to be a power forward. He will bang and get rebounds, but I think he almost already has NBA range on the three-point shot. And I think the longer he plays in the league, when he becomes a veteran, he's going to be like, if you can imagine this, another local prospect, because he's from Rice Lake, so it ain't the Mill, but it's still Wisconsin. But just imagine a physical version of Steve Novak, because all Steve could really do was be 6'10" and shoot threes. But Henry Ellison can shoot threes and do the dirty work. So that's something. And it's going to bring some energy into the building for the Bucks, man. You know, like, a lot of times we end up passing on a lot of hometown talent, you know. And this will give us a chance to kind of make up for that. You know, we passed on Kevon Looney, passed on Michael Finley back in the days. We do that a lot, but we can make it right. All right. And now, with the 11th pick in the NBA draft, the Orlando Magic select Deontay Davis, 6'10" power forward out of Michigan State. Once again, this is a dude I don't know that much about. He's a freshman. This is going to be one of those dudes that they say off of potential. You know, they claim that he's ready. I guess we'll see. And Orlando is a lot like Sacramento. It just seems like they just draft somebody at the same position every year. You know, they got like 15 small forwards. They got about 50 shooting guards. They always keep doing that. But once again, I guess you got to take the best player available. Okay, we only got three more, y'all. With the 12th pick in the NBA draft, the Utah Jazz select, okay, Furkan Korkmaz. This is a 6'7" shooting guard from Turkey. So the last dude that was nice from the NBA who came from Turkey was Hidu Turkoglu. And so this is more of a skinny dude, but they say he can shoot lights out. He got a little bit of athleticism to him, too. So that can probably help Utah out. Like, you know, if Utah was in the Eastern Conference, they probably would have been like the fifth or sixth seed in the East, you know. So the West is tough. All right. With the 13th pick in the NBA draft, the Phoenix Suns select Ivan Rabb, power forward, freshman, 6'10" out of University of California. So the reason why I say that the Phoenix Suns will have the steals of this draft is because I think they're going to go a little bit high for Jaylen Brown, because it's more of a fit instead of taking the quote-unquote best available player. They had Jaylen slated more for like the 9 and 10 range or 8 to 10 range. But now you're going to get his best friend, his college teammate from Cal at power forward. And now all of a sudden you got three young blue chip high school McDonald's All-American prospects that's all together on the NBA squad. I mean, that's something to get with. You know, you got three cats that you can build around that's all 20 years of age or younger. So I'm kind of excited to see Phoenix if they follow through on my prediction and do what I said. Okay. And so now we got the final pick, and I'm going to turn this video off, let you get back to your business, or really let you get back to watching this game. Who y'all got, by the way? I think that Cleveland is going to sweep Toronto tonight, 4-0. It's going to be the first sweep in NBA history on opening night. But with the 14th pick in the draft, the Chicago Bulls select Denzel Valentine, the National Collegiate Athletic Association Player of the Year? Or no? I got to research that, because I think Buddy Hield might have won, But I know for sure at least one of those organizations gave that Player of the Year award to Denzel Valentine. Denzel Valentine is a 6'6" shooting guard, also a senior, but he led his team in scoring and assist and was second in rebounding. So you got to understand that. That man averaged, I want to say, close to either 22 or 23 points. I know for sure it was 6 assists. Then he was right there with 7 rebounds. I mean, that's putting in some work for a college player. And if any of you guys seen Denzel play, Chicago Bulls might be on to something with that. Not sure what they're going to do in terms of putting him next to Jimmy Butler. But the thing that makes Denzel outstanding is that he can also play some point at 6'6". So don't be surprised to see the Bulls make some noise by bringing dude in. Man, this is your boy Track Lacer. I'm going to get back to this game. I'm out of here. Love. Well, not quite. It won't let me turn it off. Hold on. Okay.